Hello students, we are ready with our next video. In previous video we discussed the open chain structure of glucose and how do we arrive at the open chain structure of glucose. We discussed that in previous video. Now in today's video we will again discuss the structure of glucose in detail, but before moving in that direction I would like to show you once again a reaction of aldehyde with alcohol. As all of us know, aldehyde have a tendency to react with alcohol to give us a compound known as hemiacetal. This is a nucleophilic addition reaction. As you can see here, it is a nucleophilic addition reaction where alkoxide attack on this aldehydic center to give us a hemiacetal molecule, and this hemiacetal have a tendency to react in presence of acid. Remember, in presence of acid it react and give us a second addition of second molecule of alcohol to give us a acetyl molecule. So we can know that we should know that aldehyde to acetyl conversion always require two mole of alcohol. But in our previous video we discussed that in case of glucose molecule only one mole of methanol was consumed to give us the formation of a methanol acetyl molecule. So it was surprising, okay, why alcohol aldehyde, if it is aldehyde it should react with 2 mole of alcohol, but it was reacting only with 1 mole of alcohol. It compelled the researcher to think otherwise. It compelled the researcher to think of the fact that, okay, perhaps in case of glucose molecule, if I number the glucose molecule accordingly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I have numbered the glucose carbon atom. So why it was observed that glucose, although it is containing aldehydic part, was reacting with only one mole of alcohol. So this was explained by some theory like that, okay, perhaps it is possible that this OH must be reacting with aldehydic to give us an intramolecular reaction. Or perhaps this OH may be reacting with aldehyde to give us intramolecular reaction. So they themselves should have been forming the hemiacetal, and only they themselves must be forming hemiacetal, and this is the reason why they are reacting with only 1 mole of alcohol, because 1 mole of alcohol is given by internally by the molecule. 1 alcohol is this. This is the alcohol. Perhaps it is possible that this C4OH is reacting to give us hemiacetal, or perhaps it is also possible that C5OH is reacting to give us hemiacetal. So it was proposed that perhaps it is possible that in case of glucose, a intramolecular reaction is taking place with one of the OH group to give us hemiacetal, and second methanol was consumed. So only 1 mole of methanol was consumed to give us acetyl molecule. So what was the structure of acetyl molecule? So just by observing this theory, what was the structure observed? We will see just what was the structure observed. So it was the structure obtained by the intramolecular reaction of the alcohol in glucose molecule. Let's see the structure. Suppose we expect that this OH reacts with aldehyde, so what will be the reaction product? It will be the product. The structure of product will look like this. It is a cyclic compound, and this is a cyclic compound. We can see here is in this case is C5. C5OH is attacking on this aldehyde intramolecularly to give us this type of compound, which is known as hemiacetal. So we call this hemiacetal because I have already discussed the reaction of aldehyde with the alcohol. It exists in two forms. In two steps, first step gave us hemiacetal. So this is the hemiacetal we are getting by the reaction of this OH with this aldehyde to give us this type of structure. We can see the structure. It is a six-membered structure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 is the oxygen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is a six-membered structure. So we call it a hemiacetal. So perhaps it was proposed that glucose must be existing in a hemiacetal form. It is the reason why it was consuming only 1 mole of alcohol. So when 1 mole of alcohol was treated with this, it reacted with alcohol in acidic medium. Remember, reaction occur only in acidic medium. To give us the acetyl. So it was called acetyl. So again, we are moving from hemiacetal to the acetyl structure in presence of methanol, in presence of acidic medium, to give us this. So this is acetyl, and acetyl of glucose are called glycosides. They are called glycosides. So glycoside is a general name given for all the sugar molecule. So if a glycoside is of glucose, it is called the glucoside. if glycoside is of fructose, it is called the fructoside. So it is a specific name. Glucoside is a specific name. Fructoside is a specific name. Mannoside is a specific name, but glycoside is a general name given to all glycosides. So we observe this glycoside. So you should note the structure very carefully, that it is the reason why glucose. So after observing these, theory that intermolecular reaction was existing, so the attention was diverted from the open chain structure to the cyclic structure of glucose. So finally it was decided that it finally it was confirmed that glucose must be existing in a cyclic form, not in a open chain form. So what was the cyclic form? So it was the cyclic form of glucose. So if I delete other part, so it was finally concluded that glucose was existing in a cyclic form. And cyclic form, what was the cyclic form? The cyclic form was hemiacetal form. So it was concluded that glucose was actually existing in a hemiacetal form. It was the structure of glucose given, and it was supposed that glucose was existing in a, this form. So what was the name of this form? It form exists in a six-membered ring. So the six-membered ring, so hence the name of glucose was called D-glucopyranose. The name of this compound was called D-glucopyranose. Why be called pyranose? Because it contains a six-membered ring, and pyrene is a compound which contains six member. So by in similarity to pyrene, the pyranose term was coined, that pyranose. So the name of this compound become D is the nature of glucose, D glucopyranose. So glucose full name will be D glucopyranose. Okay, one important point which is left in our discussion is a very important point, which is called anomer or anomeric center. You can see this carbon. This carbon is a chiral center. Initially we were having four chiral center, but now we are having five chiral center. You can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In initial structure I have explained that chiral center of glucose was four, but in case of this type of cyclic structure, additional chiral center generated, and this chiral center is C. This chiral center is one which is attached with two oxygen, one with this oxygen and one with this oxygen. So carbon atom which is attached with two oxygen are called the anomeric center. So this center is called the anomeric center. So new chiral center is generated, and this chiral center oxygen is carbon attached with two oxygen. You can see here attaching with this oxygen also. So this chiral center is called the anomeric center, and there is a possibility that we can have OH on the right hand side, and there is a possibility that we can also have OH on the left hand side. So again, due to this chiral center, two forms are possible. First form, where OH is on the right hand side, is called the alpha form. And second form, where OH is on the left hand side, is called the beta form. You should take note of this very carefully, that due to the formation of cyclic structure, a glucose generated a new chiral center, and this new chiral center was called anomeric center. This is the anomeric center, and anomeric center gave us two different isomers, and these two different isomers were called anomers. So anomers is a term which is given only for glucose, not for other compound. So anomer is a term only given for glucose compounds. Only given for carbohydrate compounds. So carbohydrate compound react to give us the internal cyclic compound and this anomeric center, and HOH is alpha anomer and OHH is beta anomer. So alpha and beta are the anomeric forms. So we have discussed the anomers and anomeric forms. These are two different forms. As you can see here, OH on the right hand side is called the alpha form of glucose. OH on your beta, on OH on your left hand side, it is a beta form of glucose. So we can now, the question mark on the existence of two forms of glucose is now settled, that why glucose was existing in two different forms. Now we are able to answer all the questions why it was not reacting with sodium bisulfite. We can answer now this, that why it was not reacting with sodium bisulfite, because it is already in a aldehyde is not free. Why it is not reacting with RM Grignard reagent, because it is not, aldehyde is not free. Why it was not giving IR spectra in IR CO peak for IR spectra in IR spectroscopy, is already answered, because it is existing in a cyclic form. Now why it exists in a two different forms, why different forms were observed. Now it is, we can see here two different forms are possible, and why one mole of alcohol was used. All these questions are now settled, are now answered, due to why they're answered, because we are now moving toward from open chain structure to the cyclic structure, and cyclic structure explain all these questions which were initially raised. So clearly see the structure of glucose existing in two form, alpha form and beta form. This is commonly asked in exam. It is commonly asked in exam to write the glucose in alpha form and name it the compound. So how do we do the naming? It is a pyranose form. It is a six-membered form. So six-membered form, as all of you know, that six-membered form is called pyranose form. Pyranose form, and five-membered form I will explain later. Five-membered form is called furanose form. Right. So they are existing in a six-membered form. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is existing in a six-membered form. So it is existing in a pyranose form. So what is the, if I ask you, what is the name of this compound, these two compound name? So it will be called alpha. It is existing in D form. It is called D. It is an isomer of glucose. So gluco. Existing in a pyranose form. So pyranose. Let's see this. It is a beta form, so it is called B beta. It is existing in D form. It was D sugar, so beta D. It is isomer of glucose, so gluco. It is a pyranose, so it is called pyranose. It is the name of this compound. So commonly it is asked in exam for a question carrying 2 marks is commonly asked in exam. Write the structure of alpha D glucopyranose, or write the structure of beta D glucopyranose. So you just have to write these two different structures. Just remember, we are just trying to confuse you by giving you a very difficult name, alpha D glucopyranose. You must be getting appearing. It must be appearing very difficult for you, but it is a very simple form. That it is just a alpha D glucopyranose is alpha form of glucose, and it is a beta D glucopyranose is the beta form of glucose. Cyclic structure not only existed in six-membered form, but it can also exist in a five-membered form. So let's see how five-membered form are formed. This is glucose. Five-membered forms are formation is possible if C4OH attack on this aldehyde group. Only then we can have a five-membered ring. So when it attack on this aldehyde group, again we observe the formation of hemiacetal. These two hemiacetal form are observed, then these forms are observed after generation of again a new chiral center, and this new chiral center is this. New chiral center is observed, and this is the five-membered ring structure. You can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five-membered ring structure. So again, in case of five-membered ring structure also, two isomers are possible. This is alpha form because OH is on your right-hand side, and this is the beta form because OH is on the left-hand side. So this is alpha form and this is beta form. So if I ask you to write this name of this compound, so name of this compound will be alpha D. It is isomer of glucose, so gluco. It is a furan. So furanose. I have told you that five-membered ring are called furanose. Furanose structure are called. So name of this compound is beta D gluco furanose. Furanose. So furanose structure means The furanose structure are 5 membered form. Furanose structure are 5 membered form. So you can see here, now you can see here that glucose can exist in two different forms, 6 membered form, or it can exist in 5 membered form. In 6 membered form, it can give alpha and beta. In 5 membered form, it can give alpha and beta. So there are 4 isomers of glucose possible when we consider the glucose in a cyclic form. I have already told you that hemiacetal, when react with further molecule of alcohol, give you acetyl. So I have reacted my hemiacetal with another molecule of methanol to obtain acetyl structure. So these are the acetyl structure of my glucose molecule. I have written my acetyl structure in 2 different forms. I have written my acetyl structure in 5 membered form. I have written the acetyl structure in a 6 membered form. So as all of you know that in 5 membered also 2 forms are possible. HOR, yeah, HOR. In 6 membered also 2 forms are possible. When OCS3, H, or HOCS3. So there are 4 different isomers are possible. So I have written my glucose in a acetyl form, acetyl are also called the glycoside. I have written my glucose in a glycosidic form. So acetyl form or a glycosidic forms are same. So these are 2 forms are here possible, and here also 2 different forms are possible. Now if I ask you to name these compound, so I am just trying to explain you the naming of different compound. Suppose I name this alpha form. Name of this alpha form will be called alpha D. It is a glucose to glucopyranoside. You should know this. Initially we were discussing when it was hemiacetal, we were calling it pyranose. Now after the formation of acetyl, we are calling it glucoside. So it is a difference. You should take note of this. So alpha form, name of alpha form is alpha D glucopyranoside, and name of this beta form is beta D glucopyranoside. It is a different from pyranose, because pyranose forms are hemiacetyl form and pyranoside form are acetyl form. Now the naming of this compound, in this case I am written pyranose form, but it is not pyranose form, it is furanose form, because it is a 5 membered ring. So I'm sorry for it. Glucofuranoside and glucofuranoside. Right. Now it is right. Now the naming of this compound, this is a 6 membered ring, and 6 membered ring, you know very well, it is called pyranose form. So naming of this alpha form, if I say alpha form, so name of this compound will be called alpha D glucopyranoside. Pyranoside. Name of beta form. This beta form will be called beta D glucopyranoside. Right. So naming of different compounds. So sometimes this is a question is asked in an exam. Write the structure of alpha D glucopyranoside. That may be asked. Write the structure of beta D glucopyranoside. So you should know how to write the structure of corresponding. You just have to write the 6 membered form of glucose in beta numeric form. Write the structure of alpha D glucopyranoside. So you just have to write this as structure. So you should know how to write the structure from the name and how to write the name from the structure. It should be clear to all of you. One main difference you should note here is that I have already told you 2-3 times also, that pyranoside means acetyl or a glycoside, and pyranose means acetyl, and I'm sorry, pyranose means hemiacetyl, and pyranoside means acetyl. I repeat, pyranose means hemiacetyl and pyranoside means acetyl. So this is the structure to name or name to structure. Structure to name or name to structure should be clear to all of you, because this is a question in your exam. Always come from this section. Write in the structure or write the name of given compound. So after explaining all these points, I'm sure this must be clear to all of you. Every point must be clear to all of you. So with this, I say thanks to all of you for watching. Thank you very much.